The newly appointed Inspector General of Police, Abbas Biakagaba, and his deputy, James Ochaya, have been vetted by the Appointments Committee of Parliament. In a closed-door meeting, the duo appeared separately before the committee chaired by the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, today morning for assessment of their competencies in executing the duties they have been appointed for. Following the vetting process, Parliament will forward the report to the President, who will determine the confirmation of the duo. Some legislators expressed satisfaction with appointments, saying the President made the right choice to appoint from trained police officers instead of the military. Before one becomes IGP and Deputy IGP, they must be vetted by the committee, and if found competent, they take the oath of office.
IGP tumuyoza yoza okutuka kubuvuna izibobo. Tumusabe chintu chimu, abeerine independence ya office. Office ereme kukola munsonga za byabufuzi. Nadala munsongezo kulemesa abavuganya government.
Unze nganze atenga ntula kachiko ka defense and internal affairs akavunanyizibwa ku kitongole kya police. Kya tukoze bulunyo kubanga buli kasera tupate tu complaininga nti amaje gefuze police.
River Nyamwamba in Kasese district has burst its banks once again, flooding residential houses and crop fields. By dawn, over 4 homes had collapsed and electricity poles damaged. The most affected villages in Nyamwamba sub-county include Mombuzi, Congo Kota, Chizungu, Kisanga, among others. Luckily, no lives have been lost, except for an elderly woman who has been rushed for treatment after her residential house collapsed on her. Residents in Nyamwamba are living in fear of the swelling river and are calling for government's intervention.
The quickest intervention we need to do is to ensure we put it back in its original channel. Because even if we try to handle it from outside its channel, we may not be able to really reduce on the effect that is going to cause.
We are encouraging the families to absorb their relatives. That is the best option that we are looking at. But in an event that there is a primary school where the victims of the landslides and the mudslides are staying, we will look for options. Like if it has been a primary school, we can look for the nearby church.
Samson Mutahunga, the area local council chairperson, affirms that many people in his community have lost property to the floods, as well as the newly rehabilitated roads that were washed away. Local leaders in Ivukula Town Council in Namutumba District have vowed to step up measures against any civil servant involved in corruption tendencies. They resolved this during a community dialogue held by a team from the Inspectorate of Government that intends to create awareness on the rights of locals on monitoring funds that the government always allocates through different projects. According to the local leaders, they are faced with challenges of substandard works by contractors, delayed service delivery, and failure to implement some projects in the town council. With the training received from the IGG's office, they say this is an eye-opener on their roles and responsibilities in combating corruption. According to Musa Nduga, the mayor of Ivukula Town Council, the dialogue held in the area by the office of the IGG has come timely to empower them with tools and knowledge to hold corrupt civil servants responsible.
That it will have, for one reason, even the workers we have currently in the town council, they will work knowing that anything they are doing on ground has to be given a, there is somewhere the information is going, and there is a repercussion in case things are not have not gone right. So I know there will be some improvement.
Gerald Guira, the in-charge advocacy and research in the office of the IGG, says that government loses over 10,000 billion shillings annually through corruption. The ongoing dialogue in Busoga sub-region is intended to create awareness among communities on how to mitigate corruption.
Ekisoka nokubo nanti tutawe embere remesa. Ebintu ebyo okubawo embere remesa obukubuze nobuli yake nenguzi. So tutawo tutie mbele yu elemesa ebintu ebyo ekisoka tusomesa emisomo nga gino okutegeeza abantu ebijja mu maiso era okuba ku bantu bana mulondoole emirimu gavumenti gyekola era moniko ono mu Busoga ano nagemaganya ino n'ekyo era ejja kwongera okukinunulako. ngeri tiyemusobola okulondoola emirimu gya gavumenti.